the students that attend there are in the sixth grade, and Ms. Lena Jackson has been working with them on understanding the concepts, the basic concepts of art.
Lena J here, and working on a mural for the Great Enrichment Program, also known as GEP, as everyone likes to call it. This particular mural is the progress mural. I didn't come up with the idea behind it. Actually, the young people that I'm working with came up with it. We got it from a quote from Gandhi, "Become the change you seek." The idea behind it being that the people featured on this mural all saw that something needed to be changed in the world to make it a better place. And in their own specific way, they've all done exactly that.
We chose these people because they help the earth and have confidence to do something nobody else did before.
And the people on the murals, they have done something that nobody else could, well, nobody else did, and they try to make a difference in the world.
That you have Dorothy Counts-Scoggins, one of four African Americans to integrate the school system, endured the most abuse enduring the school system, integrating the school systems here in Charlotte, North Carolina. Then you have Sarah Stevenson, also a pioneer in the civil rights movement. She is known for integrating the Parent Teacher Association. You have Romare Bearden, one of my personal heroes. Romare Bearden is, well, he's Charlotte's own. He's a world-renowned artist working in the collage medium. Was one of the most well-known artists during the Harlem Renaissance. Then you have Harvey Gantt. If you don't know him, he was the first African-American mayor that the city has known. And last but not least, you have the current mayor, Anthony Foxx, who he's not only a classmate of mine, with Charlotte Class of 89, WC Go Lions, but he is doing so much. The thing about Anthony Foxx, where he's making a significant change, is the city of Charlotte has grown so much in such a short time under his leadership. We are the chosen city for the Democratic National Convention, which will be here this fall, when President Barack Obama will be here. And Anthony Foxx, being the mayor, will have the eye of the world. Everyone will be watching the city to see what goes on in Charlotte during the DNC when President Barack Obama is here. And it's going to be a magical time. So it was important to include him in this mural.
My name is Avion. I go to Bruns Avenue. And drawing and painting is like expressing yourself about how you feel and what you feel about people.
My name is Lanaya and I go to Alexander Graham Middle School. And I think art is very cute and funny because it makes me happy when I paint and it don't make me bored. I feel happy and creative.
My name is Danielle and I go to Bruns Avenue. And I love painting and drawing. And by doing this mural, it helps me show that I am very good at it and I'm creative.
My name is Keith and we're doing art and it's showing how people show how they helped everyone and showed everyone that they can do anything. And so I think art is like, I usually like draw with pencil and paper, but when I started to paint, it took my art to a new level, and I like to thank Ms. Lena for that.
It's amazing to see the work that they're doing after learning the basics of art to be able to put together such a beautiful thing. It's meaningful to them. It takes them out of that concept where they believe that all they have, all they do, all they're ever going to be is right outside the window. This is taking them straight to the entire world.
It's been a joy working with these young people. What can I tell you? They are all students at Bruns Avenue. A couple of others have come in. Children who are staff members. Children staff members have also helped out, but primarily they've been students from Bruns Avenue. What I can tell you about that is, it just so happens during this time. This is the month of March, 2012, and a lot of people are affected by the tragedy of Trayvon Martin's murder, which is why I'm wearing the hoodie, as well as so many others, to honor his very short life. And for me, as someone who's worked with young people for a very long time now, 14 years and counting, as an art teacher, as a facilitator, as an educator, when I look at these 12-year-olds and 13 or 14-year-olds, and some as young as 11 years old, and how many times have they walked into my classroom wearing a hoodie on, and you know, I don't see a target. I see a child. I see someone who's hungry for knowledge. I see children who've been affected by doing a project like this, by having a place to channel their creativity. And to think that someone would think of them as a threat just breaks my heart. So, you know, it was my idea that we would sort of don these hoodies as a way of, you know, saying that it could have happened to any of us, and we're all human beings. The mural will be finished by Tuesday. That's coming up next week. I've got a lot of work to do. There are about 14 of us working on it together here and there in the after school program, but of course the lion's share of it is being done by me. But I can't begin to tell you how grateful I am to have your help. It's been a group process, and again, another journey where, as it comes to an end, I'm going to miss it. I love doing these type of projects with young people. They teach me, I teach them. It works together.
This week.
Well, that's pretty much the gist of it.
There's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe.